Hi guys, and welcome back to Tropico, as Penultimo would say. I have not even completed the first little objective that we have because we need to ally ourselves with the USSR. And we've already had, we've almost completed our first little elections. I do have an absolutely amazing industry, mining industry I should say, and we seem to set up everything really well. So I can't think of this to be lasting very long, to be honest, because we basically should be already finished. We're building some modern apartment blocks for more people so they don't live in shacks. There's a crap load of people that are living in shacks over there, so... Okay, we don't need to rig the elections. We've basically won. I probably should do... God, Angry Eco, back to this, whatever. And we've unlocked a national bank, which is pretty interesting. So let's just check that. Welfare and economy. A business center? No. National bank. All right. The national bank allows new options like investments... and loans. Oh, that's pretty interesting. That's really interesting. And because we have so much money, I'm just going to buy that. And I love how each building, like the new buildings, look really, really different and unique. And they look very, very new. Anyway, it's been a couple of days since I last recorded Tropico. I gave you that extended bonus two episodes in one episode, in one video, I guess I should say. Because it was really laggy and I didn't want to disappoint you guys. So I want to make it up to you. We have a rebel threat. But, and we have a coup threat. We don't want coup threats, so let's just check our loyalists. Oh, God.
President, the U.S. Senate is not happy with you and expects urgent measures.
All right, let's do that. Let's export some chemicals for them, whatever they want. So chemicals would be... No, it wouldn't be. They'd be industry. Chemical plants.
Tropical's balance books all in the green. We seem to have a lot.
Why can't we build it there? Oh, the rocks, all right. Okay. Wow, look at that. We have $200,000. That shit must have taken so much crap. Alright, so anyway, been a couple of days since I last recorded and I gave you that special episode. And, well, we're back, really. And it took $146,000 worth of goods. Wow, we probably could build another weapons factory. But, actually, we did build our foreign ministry. Fantastic. Got a rebel attack. We have more than enough soldiers. Let's go foreign affairs and hire... I think Amanda... Yeah, oh god. Decisions. Alright, let's choose Maricela Gonzalez. It's gonna choose the other girl, but whatever. So now we have some bitch working for us. So now we can ally ourselves with the USSR. So let's go foreign affairs. Oh god. We need a... Alright. We don't have a very close relationship with the USSR. Damn. Bad relations with the communist faction. What do the communist faction want? Healthcare and insufficient housing. Okay, I guess you do want more houses, so that makes sense. So let's try to squeeze something in here, if we can, like so. Just one in there, and the hospital, that's what we want. Just to shut more people up, and that's in welfare and economy. Wasn't I just there? Hospital, there we go. Sometimes I can be just such a derp. And anyway, a couple of interesting developments have been happening for my channel. I have been in contact with Machinima because my channel has grown so much. And I was just like, well, I sent a letter of resignation to Machinima. I wanted to leave them and I wanted to join another network because they were offering much better things and much better pay as well. And like a lot more freedom, etc. But I just highlighted like my, I gave them a pretty professional letter, Machinima, of like why I wanted to leave. And well, we're just in contact and just talking with each other about problems, etc., etc. And thankfully they've fixed all the problems, or at least most of them, and they're doing their best to like fix all the problems. And we have way too many shacks over here, so let's just quick build that. And yeah, we were just in contact and I was just venting my problems with them, and thankfully they've been really good. They've been fixing my problems, and I really can't get into too much because with Machinima you do sign a non-disclosure agreement, so you can't really talk about anything. So, and we have repelled the rebels, which is great. Let's quick build that because we can definitely afford to quick build everything. Oh god. And yeah, so a couple of interesting things are going to be happening. I will have a live stream function on my channel, which is great. Hopefully, I've tried to... Just shut up, I want to talk. I could lower his volume, but I'm not going to. So yeah, I've tried to live stream on Twitch, but it's really, really like laggy, and because Australian internet, I can only upload at 90 kilobytes a second at my maximum, because we don't have Annex M yet in my area. So with Annex M, you can upload at like 3 megabytes a second, which is a heck of a lot faster, but still not the best, but it'll be a large improvement over what I have now, and we're getting that soon. Not yet, but soon, so can't wait for that. And well, apart from that, I'm getting the live streaming function on my YouTube channel, so I will be able to live stream on YouTube now for you guys, which is very, very exciting. Hopefully it'll be very good, like the with the live streaming, etc. How have we not run out of power yet? Where's this? Oh god, dismissed him. We still have more than enough power, I guess. Alright. Bureaucrats for sale. Okay, buy a bureaucrat. Fantastic. Now, we should be able to ally ourselves with the USSR now, really. Still not. Alright. We need to help out the communists. It's still at 70%, so that's pretty good. But, we need better healthcare. Okay. How many... Oh God, maybe... How about we lower this to $0 rent? Maybe that'll work out. So yeah, I'll be having a live streaming capabilities on my channel, which is very, very exciting for you guys. And also, with Machinima and YouTube, they're obviously really, really close together, because Machinima is the largest network on YouTube, and there's a fair few networks already on YouTube. Like, there's gaming networks, but there's also like entertainment networks, which Machinima also has expanded into, like Maker Studios and things like that. But Machinima is the biggest one, and YouTube and Machinima are really, really tight with each other. They help out. So that's why Machinima is like really, really good to be with, because whenever you have a problem like a copyright strike, they can just get in contact with YouTube right away, and it can get sorted out. So basically, that's it. If any of you care, I'm sure many of you guys will care about the live streaming, because I guess that's pretty interesting for you guys. Hopefully we'll be getting that really soon. And also, oh yeah, mobile views. That's what I wanted to say. You bastards that watch these videos on mobile views, etc. I think there'll be ads now, because I'm going to be starting to get paid with my monetized... With ads? No. With mobile views. I'll be getting paid for mobile views as well, because previously we haven't been able to get paid for mobile views. But with this new contract that I'm getting, I have mobile views, so... I think that's about it that I can say right now. Well, we do have to sign a non-disclosure agreement, so I really can't say too much. But I'm sure many of you guys are interested, like, with the live streaming and stuff. So that is why I mentioned that. We have basically no shacks now. We don't have enough generals, really. We have more than enough. What are you talking about? Look at all that money. Far out. Which you... All right, there we go. Look at that. USSR, 100% relations. That went way too quick. Okay. Now, we go over here, foreign affairs, ally with the USSR, yes. Alright, so they have a military base on our island. Right, let's put the two military bases right next to each other then. But it's no different. It's basically exactly the same, just that we have it on different angles, really. So, alright. Oh, so you don't have to even build it. Nice, it's just like quick built.
Privetствие, Presidente. I am General Igor Fedorov. We have a mutual enemy.
Privetstvem. I know how to speak Polish, so sometimes Russian and Polish, you can like sort of understand what they're trying to say, what Russians are trying to say if you understand Polish, but I don't really understand what that means. But anyway, my comrades in the Kremlin fight a cold war against the evil capitalist empire, but you and I both know the true name of our adversary. I intend to confront the conclave and destroy them, even if you are based on American soil. If they are based on American... Your island is the perfect place for establishing a naval base of operations against our clandestine foes. We'll need at least 5 docks to... What? to establish the basic infrastructure needed to move my plans forward. Become my ally and I will tell you more. Construct... Well, I am your ally. Construct 5 docks. You will lose the game if the time limit expires. Alright, let's just slow everything down, because I can quick build. And actually, can we build on this side? Yeah, we can. I'm going to build a couple on this side. So that's why they included docks like a beach on this side. So we go over here, and I think it will be in infrastructure. Dock, yes. Talking about submarines, supposedly the North Koreans released a couple of submarines of theirs from some naval dock, naval base, and they haven't been spotted since for about 3 or 4 days. I haven't heard anything about it since, which is rather interesting. And talking about that, they're going to be... What am I looking at? Infrastructure. They're going to be launching that supposed satellite into space, which what I've been reading about is basically impossible on the trajectory that they've... well, it's extremely dangerous, like, because for the thing that they're launching, they're going to be launching, like, a satellite, supposedly, into space that will look over their forests and, like, lands and basically all their mining resources. It will look for mining resources and things. It will be able for them to look over their crops and just for national security. But for that, you need, like, a geosynchronous orbit, which is, like, in parallel with North Korea all the time. So it just... It's basically stationary over... It moves as fast as the Earth.
Here we go. We received intelligence that you are well on your way to winning the trust of Fedorov, Presidente. Everything is proceeding according to our plan.
I swear she had a voice change, Agent Sasha. And it didn't really take that long, did it? The general talks about shadowy organizations and a global conspiracy. The KGB knows nothing about such things. They are probably the ramblings of delusional, xenophobic, and megalomaniac. Oh, xenophobic megalomaniac. No offense meant, Presidente. However, even if Fedorov is right and his so-called conclave is indeed based in the USA, he is still a dangerous man and can easily provoke World War III if he commits to a course of open aggression. Continue to work with him for now, but be careful. I will keep you updated.
Communism will soon be upon us. 3 cheers for progress, comrades!
Yes, because communism definitely does lead to progress. We have 4 docks now. Let's just build another one. So yeah, they need so the flight path that the satellite is going to be going on isn't in line with a geosynchronous orbit. So basically, they're just bullshitting the North Koreans as usual. Bunch of fuckwits, the North Koreans, honestly. Anyway, is that right? It is connected. These are all connected. All right, just quick build. Speed up. Oh no, not menu. Speed up time. That's what we want. Alright, fantastic. Oh, here we go. There's ships up there.
I welcome you as my ally, Comrade Presidente. Let us invade Alaska.
Oh, God. Nyets, nyets. Don't be alarmed. It's on good authority that the secret headquarters of the Conclave is located in the snowy wastes of Alaska. It is poetic, no? With one decisive strike, we can cut off the head of the snake, take back Alaska, and expose American conspirators. The next world war will be inevitable, but we are ready to fight and die for our motherlands. It will be a glorious victory for communism, but we are not yet ready to attack. You have to stop Fedorov from invading Alaska while pretending to work with him. If the invasion countdown reaches zero, you will lose the game. How do we stop him from reaching... Oh, God. You know what? I'm just going to have to save this right now. Save, blah, blah, blah. All right. Hopefully, that save will save us from anything that could happen, potentially. We have a rebel attack. We probably could do with a bit more of an army. And, oh god.
The Russian agent tells us one thing. Fedorov tells us another, Presidente. Don't know who to trust? You should always trust science. Ergo, me.
Damn right, you should always trust science. With a modest research grant of 30 grand, I can come up with a sophisticated technological solution to all our problems within months. I'm sure you are capable of that. We just wanted more power. Well, I wanted more power. Okay.
Comrade Sunny, I am happy to be here among our brothers in Tropico to spread the light of communism for future generations.
Alright, so I want a cathedral, so welfare and economy. Cathedral. I just want to shut the religious people up because a couple of the factions really didn't like me. And we want a mausoleum as well, so no, not luxury. Landmarks and beauty mausoleum. Alright, and quick build that as well. How much money is this ship going to be taking? 65 grand. We are making more than enough money. Alright, bomb threat resolved successfully because we paid everyone off. We don't have any shacks in here, do we, anymore? Oh, well, we have a couple more. It's time to build another modern apartment block. Here, where can we fit it in? Oh, no, we can't fit it in. How about if we... There we go. How's that for town planning? Let's zoom back in. Oh, look at the... Oh, God, here we go.
So, the good General Fedorov is preparing to invade Alaska, right?
Mm-hmm.
I know a commodity that can delay his efforts.
Export enough rum, and I will make sure that it reaches his soldiers. Export 500 rum. Invasion preparations will be delayed. All right. Oh, God, what am I doing? That was a pretty cool reflection. All right. So. Just pause everything. Yes, pause. Now that everything's paused, let's set up a industry around rum. So a rum distillery. Yes, rum distillery. Where should we have it? Probably over here. Maybe we should build a couple. Industry rum distillery. Alright, I'm probably not going to have anywhere near enough workers, but... Hey, you know what? Whatever. Quick build. Alright, I had it on pause. I'm wondering, why are they not building? Makes sense, alright. Okay, allow imports. Yes. Okay, so each of these... oh, God, here we go.
At last, my latest / greatest invention is now complete. Behold, the plans for an advanced electronics factory that is at least a decade ahead of its time.
All right, so this looks like we're going to be having a new, complete new industry, which is very cool for the Modern Times DLC. So I guess we're supposed to get this in 1991, but we get it 10 years ahead of its time. So he gets even better, Presidente. All electronics exported by such factories will be rigged with ingenious microtransmitters, sending information to us. Just export enough electronics and you will have an infallible spy network across the entire planet. We'll only be able to pull this trick once, but it will surely reveal who is telling you the truth and who is lying. Okay, that's been pretty cool. What does it say up here? And we unlock those metro stations. Alright, great. Okay, we have a couple workers in here. Even if it's not that many. So, let's just hire a couple workers. And actually, because there's so many ships coming in, that means we're going to have a crapload of, like, chances to have immigrants, like skilled people that we're buying out. So as you can see, that just came. Let's buy a couple of these guys. A couple more. All right, independent politics, whatever. I really just could not care what you've got to say, to be honest. What do you need for this? Oh, okay, it's not connected to the electrical grid. All right, let's connect it. Electric substation. I wonder if that'll spread. Like, if we quick build this, if it will spread all the way down here. Do you guys reckon? It does. Fantastic. Nice. All right. Let's get a couple more workers. They seem to be leaving for something else, but not that I really care. Okay. Bugged electronics, so... Oh, God. It'll be an industry. There we go. Electronics factory. Produces electronics from bauxite or gold. And or gold, I think it said. Yep. Okay, ooh, it looks like we could probably do with a bit more power as well. So before we build, get all that, so let's just build a Teamsters office. One up here. Another Teamsters office up here. And another one, because we have been neglecting the Teamsters offices. Quick build. Okay, and now for some garages up around here. So, garage, and where can we squeeze them in? Probably over here. There we go. Let's get one more. I don't think the garages are that important. As important as the Teamsters offices, but I guess we'll have to see. There's a couple more shacks. This house is nearly being built, so that's great news for me. I really do want to export that rum really quickly, though. So let's see. We have a... They need... the chemical plant. Oh, that's the chemical plant. I want this. I think this is completely new as well. Is it? Tropical medicine cures everything. Side effects include sudden death. Jeez, what the hell is that sound? No. Some painful death. The service quality of all clinics. Let's do that. All right. Nutrient additives. All right. You guys better be producing some good chemicals really soon. All right, we've almost exported all the rum that we can export. And the electronics store. Should we allow exports? Let's just check this. Oh, we do have all these bauxite mines. There's gold up here as well. Huh. We basically exploited everything, except I think our rebels lost over here, maybe? That's kind of disappointing. Alright. Got lots of army generals, etc. So what does this do? It raises production by... here we go.
Nazdarovya, comrade. My men have encountered some unforeseen consequences that will delay the invasion campaign a bit.
Alright, so Nazdarovya means for good health, basically. So, as I mentioned, like, Russian and Polish is very, very similar. Alright. Nevertheless, we'll be ready as soon as we finish drinking. I mean, drilling. Drilling. How about your men, Presidente? Are they ready? They are also drunk, I am afraid. Lose 30 respect for the militarists. Or, yes, they are. We can attack whenever you recover. Ooh. It'll probably go down up a little faster, but anyway. We have a drought.
A drought, Presidente. Mother Nature is gently reminding us how many resources we consume.
Alright, set the water restrictions. Okay, so with this, we don't have to, like, production decrease by 25%, but we don't need to spray the crops or anything like that, which is nice. I do want to increase production. There's a chance that our US relations may suffer by 20 because of our nightly production plans. Oh, pirate shop. Nice. Nice. And, so that's... Okay. So, in an electronics factory, you have a pirate shop. Nice. Clean room. The export price for electronics will be increased by 15%. Cumulative among several electronics factories. Nice. And what does this do? We don't have enough power, really? You gotta be kidding. How about now? And this is consumer electronics line. 60 meg... Oh, that's why... Wow. Alright. We have all the power we can possibly wish for. And I'll probably want to build another electronics factory.
That charming Soviet agent Sasha contacted me last night, Presidente. After a heated discussion, we both agreed that rum alone cannot delay the efforts of General Fedorov forever. It's time to turn to the fine arts.
It is indeed. Have a theater or burlesque mode to just... theater on burlesque mode to distract General Fedorov. The invasion plans will be destroyed. Alright, theater it is then. So, entertainment. Theater. Right up here. Quick build it. Why is this not producing any chemicals, though? I have no idea. Alright, it's raining, man. Whatever, blah, blah, blah. Have it on burlesque. There we go. And finally, we're exporting those chemicals and also... almost all those bugged electronics. I wanted to build another bugged electronics store or electronics factory, but we don't really need to. That's really cool that we get new buildings all the time. And they have a lot of resources left lying around, as you guys can see. Hopefully a steamster comes up by really soon and they'll be gone. We'll see if anyone's actually going to come up and take that. Please, hopefully. Rebel attack. All right. Oh, we've won. At the mausoleum. We can actually even rig the mausoleum with booby traps. Okay, whatever. I think she actually had something important to say, but whatever. So we basically completed these two missions. At least the bugged electronics. We have unlocked an aerodome, so let's just check that. Requires Minister for the Economy of Economy. Okay. I just wanted to... Oh, what? Rebels have been repelled. What happened over here? Oh, here we go.
We exported more than enough listening devices, Presidente. Off to the radar dish to decode the encrypted signals. What do you mean I didn't tell you about the radar dish?
I was just going to say, so I'm positive I told you that we need a radar dish to make any sense of the intel provided by our microtransmitters. Or possibly I meant to tell you, but got distracted. Anyway, you'd better build at least 5 of them, 1 to decode the messages and 4 more to distract any enemy agents trying to sabotage our plans. Alright, before I do that, what happened over here? Our college got... something happened to it. Kind of disappointing. Look at all these houses that we have lying around. Wow. What do you want?
Logia Novosti, Presidente. Just as I was putting the final touches on the invasion plan, your advisor Penultimo informed me that your army is quite busy fighting rebels here in Tropico.
He is lying to me, is he not? He is right, we do have minor rebel infestation. Moreno will send 10 rebels for authenticity. I think Moreno is like the head rebel guy, and we dealt with Moreno and the likes of him a long time ago. Invasion counter will progress. Whatever, we can deal with that easy. Went down to 76, but alright, whatever. Let's build those radar dishes then. It's not entertainment, it's in education and media. Yes. 1, 2. Oh god, what am I clicking on? Sometimes I worry myself too much. Education and media, 3, 4, and oh god. 5. Now let's quick build. There we go. Quick build.
A new radar dish has been placed on the island, but nobody knows its purpose. Penultimo, can you give us more details? Right.
Honey, I assure you, I did not have with that woman.
I'm sorry, Sonny. Did you say
you're not gonna read anything, Dr. Steinschneider? Fine. We got the data, Presidente. Unfortunately, we've got a bit too much data. Our bugs have been transmitting everything from everywhere they ended up, and filtering that important information from the garbage is not a trivial task. For 20 grand, we can outsource it to a small Chinese team of 10,000 specialists. It's $2 a person. Nice. They guarantee to do the job practically immediately, or against my better judgment, we can use the local talents for free, even if you manage to keep Miss Pineapple from distracting them. I estimate that the process will take months at least. Paid the 20 grand, we'll see what Pineapple's got to say.
I am astonished, Presidente. We now know that both Fedorov and Sasha are not actively trying to deceive you. However, the Conclave headquarters is not actually located in Alaska. This is false data, intentionally fed to Fedorov by the Conclave.
Dun dun dun. Alright, the shadowy organization manipulates him like a puppet on a string, urging him to go ahead with his invasion plans and trigger a conflict on a global scale. My hypothesis is that they hope to capitalize on the chaos and establish a new world order in the aftermath of the war. Not a bad idea, actually. Fedorov will not accept all this on trust. With the intelligence we received from the bugs, it should be relatively easy to capture an agent of the Conclave. Have 3 secret agents. Alright, where's the theater that we have over here? So I think we need a Minister for the Interior for secret police. Requires a squad HQ as well. Let's build a squad HQ. Alright, we need a Minister for the Interior. Let's just build, or get him. Interior, hire, yes, whatever. Well, we should have one coming in right any, there we go. There's one coming up here. Are you going to bring in a Minister for the Interior? Yes, alright. So now that means we can build Government Squad HQ. Well, it needs to be built where there's crime, so over here somewhere. Let's just click and hope for the best if we can unlock something. Please, please, please. No. Oh, yep. There we go. Quick build. Nice. Alright, and that enables us to do what exactly? It enables us to get the edict of the secret police. That's what we wanted. Secret police. Activate. Yes, yes, yes. Alright. Let's hire three people. Whatever, we can burn the money. It really doesn't bother me if... There we go. What? A couple of miners are working here? Nice. It's quality. Alright. So, Dr. Steinschneider should come up any moment now and just explain himself.
Your agents managed to capture one of the Conclave's diversion and remove the cyanide capsule from his tooth? Zamechatana!
Alright. I will travel to your island to personally supervise his interrogation. I've met his kind before. Conclave agents are physically conditioned to resist all kinds of torture. The only way to get something out of him will be to treat him with a truth serum in a specialized facility. Have a sanatorium on psych ward work mode. It's a bit of a tongue twister. Alright, so we've got three new foreign. Okay, whatever, whatever. So we should go to infrastructure. I think the sanatorium is in. No, it's actually helped. Well, there we go. Let's see where we can put it. Over here. We're basically running out of land over here. We should start expanding maybe. But I'm glad I took the first, like, episode, the first couple of episodes, I should say, just, oh god.
Proclatia, this has to be the second most problematic invasion of Alaska I have ever planned, Presidente.
Alright, this morning I almost gave the order for our joint attack, but General Rodriguez reported that your army is still not ready. What is your excuse now? Our forces... Okay, whatever. We can allow the invasion to progress. Let's quick build that and set it to psych ward mode, or psych ward work mode. What? Oh, ouch. Alright. So, god damn, welfare and economy, stock exchange, national bank. Actually, we have a national bank, so. Slush funds. Siphons money from the treasury to the Swiss bank account. Efficiency depends on the skill of the bankers. No effect when the country is in debt. Currently siphons $0 a month, which is no good. There we go, $105 a month. What if we increase their pay? Will that do anything? I don't think so. How else can we get more money into our, stale money? Offer Tropicans a chance to toll endlessly so you can make a few bucks. I think that this might work as well. And I haven't built the business center yet, so let's go ahead and do that. Over here. Quick build. It's going to be one of the highest buildings that we have in the game. Almost higher than the tower that we can build for tourism. There we go. And what does this do? With several cardboard walls, you can increase the office stress and double the number of workers in this building to increase the job quality by 10%. So, water coolers. The water coolers are an important social hub in the office. The mere existence of such a facility increases the job quality by 20. Let's do that. Wow, look at all those workers. They're uneducated. They're probably like a call center or something. No, we don't want that. Can you, like, give me any money, please? Oh, God.
Thank the heavens, my Presidente. For a moment, I thought that assassin whatever. Got you.
Oh, God. I want more money in my slush fund. So, that was, like, we can only do that. Have a sanatorium on psych ward work mode. Alright. That sucks. How much do I have in my Swiss bank account?
What do you want? I'm busy ruling.
I guess earned on this map, 1298. I think that's what they want. So I need 7,500. Alright. Oh, fuck this. Let's just give them the best wages that they can possibly afford. Maybe it'll help them out. And also, it would probably, the National Bank would probably work a lot faster. Let's just give them a bit smaller wages. And because we need tourists in here, which is kind of interesting for a national bank, but all right, so let's build that aerodrome. That was in tourism, requires a minister of the economy. So, a ministerio economy, Yes, you, whatever. Some random bastard. Now, let's go to Tourism, Aerodome. Up here. Quick build while we're at it. Connected to a road if possible at all. Nope, doesn't seem like it's going to be possible like so. Damn. Bit of a pickle that one is. Let's see. Nope. Alright, that sucks. Yeah. Well, we've almost exported all the chemicals, so the US relations should increase. Oh god, okay, check this. It's going up to 1900, so it's going to take a little bit of a while. Hopefully the invasion countdown doesn't increase to some ridiculously large amount, though. That would suck. But we finished with the chemicals, which is great news for me. Oh wow, we don't have any guys in our army base, really? That's kind of disappointing. I guess they all moved to some other buildings. Like over here. And why? Wow, why did so many of you guys stop working? Where did all of them go? Probably over here. No? Where would all of them go? Maybe over here, then. Huh. I don't know. Whatever, let's just increase this still. Give him, leave it at like 32 or something. Because I really don't want this to reach a zero. If it reaches zero, then we have failed. So let's just give him that. Give him maximum amounts of money. There we go. They all came back. I don't know what happened. We probably shouldn't set this. Wait. Immigration office, set it to immigration is forbidden. There we go.
Great.
Going down to 33. Oh, we unlocked a modern condominium. Nice. Cost way too much. 12 grand. All right, so the tourists should be coming in. The airport will be equipped to service charter planes. Additional tourists will arrive on the island. With the second terminal and it. Okay. We could use all those things. What does this do?
A unique opportunity to sabotage Fedorov's invasion plans has presented itself, Presidente.
Fantastic.
We will only need a few crates of monkey wrenches, and we are good to go.
All right. However, we do have a small problem. The funding for the operation cannot come from the KGB or indeed anywhere in the USSR. Fedorov has too many connections here. Nevertheless, the cost is modest, and I am certain that you can take care of it. Fantastic. We definitely needed invasion plans to be slowed down, so let's do that. Thankfully, it slowed down. Wow, that was definitely very stressful. I wonder if we'll get there in time. But I guess we'll have to do that next episode because I've been recording for a very long time and my mouth is starting to get really sore from talking way too much. So anyway, guys, hopefully you have enjoyed and we'll be back very soon with the next episode. And hopefully we will have this finished very soon.